12. This is only the second one of its kind I have cataloged in our 7 years on this island. On this island.
What is this?
Wild boar. They're good to eat.
Maybe there are more around.
We don't need more. You try to kill only what you can eat.
Your mother! I did see it. It was smoke.
I understand.
I saw it.
I didn't.
Don't eat with your fingers, David.
It's very good, dinner. About Hutt. What about Bird? Turtle.
It's too long a word for him. He's not ready for that.
I know a word. Train.
What's a train?
Well, it can go real fast, fast as a deer. And you go inside it and it takes you anywhere you want. And it carries lots of people.
Lots of people?
Well, you're people, and you're people, and I'm people, and the world's full of people.
Let me get some more. Stop it, David. Don't want to hear that right now. David.
It's so painful to you. Why do you keep it around? Why don't you get rid of it?
I can't help being the way I am. I don't have your strength. Need patience.
Not as strong as you think I am.
Do you remember that big grandfather elm that stood right outside the nursery? It was dying for so many years and we wouldn't let the gardener take it down. Fine, it looked in the winter with the snow all over its branches. Did any of that ever really happen? The difference between us is that you've come to accept it. Sometimes I actually get the feeling you almost enjoy it here.
Well, you've got to admit it's an ideal setting for a man in my field. What wouldn't some of my distinguished colleagues at the Academy give for a chance to live like Darwin? No speeches, no papers, no directors to appease, no boards to satisfy. The exquisite luxury of making mistakes without giving a damn. Here, I am always right.
They came to the island in a storm. By the grace of God, the three of them remained aboard ship and survived, while the others abandoned ship and perished. Bit by bit, they made a life for themselves. They raised their child. They nurtured each other in sickness and despair. And they lived. For 7 long years, they lived. And were forgotten and died.
You're not dead yet.
It's hopeless.
Never hopeless.
How far is any place?
1,000 miles, maybe.
They'll never find us.
There's always a chance.
They'll never find us. About him.
Told you not to do that. Do you understand me? You are not to leave the house and come out here alone at night.
Maida.
Never.
Maida, it's all over.
No! It's not over. It's not over. No, you understand. It'll never be over. No! Get us out of here! Get us out of here! Get me out of here!
Ah.
8 o'clock.
Very good, David. That's right.
The big hand's on the 10, the little hand's on the 2, so it's 2:10.
No, darling, 2:10.
Twelve noon.
Right. Or 12:00.
Time is a dimension invented by man for use in a civilized society. It has no meaning here. For us, the important points of time are day and night.
Can we do some more, Mother?
No, that's fine for today.
Inviting him into a world he will never see. By giving him dreams he will never fulfill, appetites he'll never satisfy.
What do you want me to do? Shall I bring him up as an animal? Should we all become beasts because we're forced to live among them?
Should accept reality as it is. And always will be.
It's strange. I was the one who'd given up hope. Now it's you.
Listen to me, Rita. Last night, if we hadn't gotten there when we did, he would have been torn to pieces. In the jungle, sometimes you can live or die in a matter of seconds. You know what I thought of out there? I thought of David, an older David, alone and helpless at the mercy of nature. He would neither understand nor be able to cope with it. And he will be alone one day. When you and I are dead, he will have to manage on his own. He's got to be taught. Not words and letters and the way of a world he will never know, but the ways of the jungle, the ways of the beast that he must master and know if he's going to survive. That's what I thought about it. Now, I'm going to see to it that he develops feet that make no sound, eyes that can see in the dark, ears that can hear that leopard feeding in its lair. Don't need these anymore. From now on, the jungle will be his school. The jungle will be his life. Among all this beauty, there is never-ending menace. Nothing is safe. Death is everywhere. The strong survive. The weak die. That's the first law of the jungle, David. Watch.
him whole and then sleep in the sun. That's when we take him.
It's a little frog.
That's right. And if we opened it up, we'd probably find something inside, too.
They all eat each other.
That's the life chain of nature. The snake ate the heron. The heron ate the fish. The fish ate the frog. The strong eat the weak in order to survive.
Every Saturday night, there was a dance at somebody's house. There was music, charades, and lots of wonderful things to eat. Cakes, ices, and punch. My father used to make punch in a huge crystal bowl. Oh, my. The dances at our house were the best. All the girls and boys wanted to be invited to them. Oh, my. How we danced and danced. Round and round. Under the chandeliers. The boys so handsome. The girls so beautiful.
David, I need your help.
Catch a panther.
You ready, David?
He doesn't want to come.
I can't say as I blame him.
It'll be dark soon.
It's the best time to hunt a panther.
You'll be away all night?
Just keep the light going. You'll be all right.
David?
Must not move, cough, nothing.
But the mosquitoes.
Endure them.
Take them home?
They're wild creatures, Dad. They may seem harmless enough now, but when they grow up, they become your enemies. They try to kill you.
Well, what'll we do? Just leave them here?
Kill them.
Kill them?
You kill them.
Rub the wood ash in deeply and slowly.
I killed it. I killed three of them.
They were babies.
Well, when they grew up, they could have killed me.
They might never have crossed your path.
Better get some sleep, David.
It's unbelievably cruel.
Life is cruel. That's the whole point.
every living creature, all flesh, thou shalt bring two of a sort into the ark, that they may live with thee, of the male sex and the female, of fowls according to their kind, and of beasts in their kind, and of everything that creeps on the earth according to its kind. Two of every sort shall go into the ark with thee, that they may live. Thou shalt take into the ark food that may be eaten, and it shall be food for thee and them, the animals.
From the smallest insect to the largest animal. The most beautiful act in the world of living creatures.
But what are they doing to each other?
They're making little ones.
Is that how you and Mother made me?
That's how all animals make babies. Can't have anymore.
It's for him. It's for his life. Try to understand.
I am trying to understand, but I'm afraid.
David. Oh, well, don't you want it anymore?
No, dear. Those things are no good to me here. Here, help me with these.
Mother, I saw
saw you and Father in bed last night.
Oh?
You were doing what the animals do when they make babies.
It's not very nice to look.
Why not?
Just isn't. You must never do that again.
Father says you can't have any more babies. Then why do you do it?
Well, because we're in love. When two people are married, they do everything for each other. What you saw is very beautiful.
Well, if it's beautiful, then why can't I look? Mother?
Yes?
Can we get married when I grow up?
David, you are such a funny child.
He's growing.
Soon he'll be able to go into the jungle alone.
Soon he'll be nothing more than a savage.
Thank you. Salt.
I have work to do.
Among the Barongo tribe of South Africa, the boy speaks to his mother only with embarrassment. Should he venture into her hut, he greets her in a trembling voice. In Melanesia, the reserve between a son and his mother increases as the boy achieves adolescence. Should his mother bring him food, she does not hand it to him. Puts it down for him to take. I have work to do. Beautiful skin. You put up a good fight?
Could have killed me. But I killed him.
You've learned well, son.
I learned what you taught me.
Is looking at me. The little gifts. His pathetic little attentions. In heaven's name. We've got a lusting male with no outlet. What he needs
cities. Dances, music, parties. Punch in a huge crystal bowl. Dancing round and round the chandelier. You were good at telling stories.
Thought one day you'd see it all.
You never believed it. But you made me believe it. Tell me. Jane Renoyer, 1892.
You and I mustn't be together anymore.
Because of David.
Because of David. And what we're doing to him.
All right. I'll sleep in the lab from now on.
Maida. Wait. It's too punishing.
It's the only way we can live.
It's insane.
We're all insane.
David, wait a moment, please.
David?
Wait! Don't come any farther. Mother, please! No! I'll show you. For you! Mother!
John! 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 John!
John? John?
Mother? Mother?
What is it? What do you want?
I've got to talk to you.
Tomorrow?
No. I want to talk to you now. I have to talk to you. May I talk to you, Mother? I've been reading this book. You said it was the book of truth. It says here, and Adam knew Eve, his wife, and she conceived and bare Cain and said, I have gotten a man from the Lord, Cain, her son, the first three people in the world. And here it says, and Cain knew his wife, and she conceived and bare Enoch. Mother,
Who was Cain's wife? There weren't any other women.
Go away, David.
Was it Eve? Was it his mother? Who was Cain's wife? Who was Cain's wife? Adam was dead, wasn't he?
He's in there somewhere, watching us.
We survive.
Is there any chance for us at all?
Of course.
If there were a chance, you'd have built this raft long ago.
With luck, the current will carry us into the shipping lanes.
When do we leave?
Morning tide is best.
did it.
Yes.
Thank you.
Please kill me.
There's no need. Nature will do it.
The life chain of the jungle, huh?
That's right. The strong eat the weak in order to survive.
Oh, man!